eating fucking tacos in Tijuana and then having some coconut ice cream to cool it down.
Come on, ice cream.
You know, fucking little coconut flakes fucking flying out your ass.
Oh, God. Oh.
You know those little ice cream bars they sell, like, in A-Town or, you know, the...
Yeah.
They walk around their little carts in the street. Uh-huh. They sell the ice cream bars.
Yes.
They do that in your neck of the woods stuff?
I don't recall. I only recall having seen an ice cream cart once, and I... Or maybe it was a little truck. I can't remember. Once last summer, I think. I don't... Yeah, well, 2020 was not a year to fucking gauge anything by, so who knows? As the weather gets warmer, we'll see.
Yeah, I remember this one time, me and Serge were working in Elgin, over on the east side, and we saw this cart, and the guy had... Like, we went and got lunch somewhere. We got some Mexican food. It was pretty good. And then we were, like, walking back to the truck or something. And we'd seen this guy with a cart, and he was selling mangoes on a stick. And a peeled mangoes. And Serge's like, oh, dude. He's like, oh, you ever have a peeled mango on a stick? He's like, they're so good, you know? I was like, no, man, give it a try. And he had, like, this chili shaker.
Yeah.
And he would, and we figured it was like kind of, you know, like kind of mild chili, you know?
Yeah.
And, anyway, so he like, Serge's like, oh yeah, the guy sprinkled some on like a little bit. And Serge's like, oh no, man, go for it, you know? And, so he just douses the fuck out of the mango with this powdered chili. And I don't know what the fuck it was, dude, but it was so fucking hot. Like, Serge was like, trying to eat it, dude, and he can't because it's too fucking hot.
Uh-huh.
He's burning his mouth, and he's like, Jesus Christ, man. He's like, what kind of fucking spice was it? He's like, holy fuck. It was like habanero or something, man. It was just fucking hot as hell, you know?
Full-on Mexican dude fucking sweating it out, can't take it.
Yeah, but usually those put, like, kind of mild chili on, you know? It's kind of, like, a little sugar in it or something, you know? Just like a... kind of a mixture on the fruit, but this shit was like full on, like fire fucking dust, man.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah, he loaded it, you know, on both sides. He's like, chuck, 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 chuck. Fucking Serge is just like,
Serge trying to flex his Mexicanness. He's like, oh man, yeah. Load it up. He's like, oh my God.
His mouth is burning, his eyes are watering.
Yeah, mouth full of fire. Holy shit.
It was too, man. I had it on mine. I didn't get quite as much, but I was just like, damn, that shit's hot. It was a dirty trick, I tell you.
Excuse me. Well, it's a funky snack, too.
So, yeah.
So there you go.
Yeah, I got some crazy fucking treats, I'll tell you what.
Well, at least it's not the pastries. The pastries, yeah. I can't do it, man. I tasted six different ones, and I've tasted them all. It's cool.
Yeah, I actually saw a van on the highway the other day, and it was like this Mexican pastry van that probably delivered to like different Super Mercados, but it had like the pictures of all the like yellow and pink pastry fucking shit on the side.
Yeah.
You know, the buns with like the little white fucking, and I was just like, oh God, fucking, they really have a fucking delivery thing for that. Fucking, yeah, making all the same shit, delivering it all around.
Yeah, it's a fucking brain dead job. Imagine the plant that fucking cranks all that shit out. It's like, fuck. Hey, go over and get some more.
You're never gonna want to sit there and like eat them fucking on the side. And, like,
go no, to the break room. Like, never worry about
you go in the break room and it's just like, ah.
Never worry about loss prevention or anything. They're not gonna, oh God, they're like, no, it's cool. Go get some more sesame seeds and some honey or whatever the fuck. Groovy. Just get a few tons, man. We'll use it. We'll just make 16 different shapes and shit.
Or like that real sugary, like a, what is it? It's like a kind of like candy corn, but it's like this thick, sugary brown, like a...
Like marzipan?
No, I don't think it's not marzipan. It's just like sweet. You know how the candy corns are like just like this sugar,
sure.
Thick sugar? Yeah, they have like this brown candy, and it comes in like four or five shapes. It's all the same fucking flavor. And it's like eating a big hunk of candy corn. It's fucking gross.
Yummy.
Have you ever tried that?
No.
Yeah, like a bite or two is good, but any beyond that, it's
pure sugar. I avoid shit like that if I can.
Yeah, I used to get it when I was a kid. Like in Aurora once in a while. I'd be like, oh, yummy, because it's all sweet.
Oh, yummy.
But it has no, like... actual flavor. There might be some vanilla in it or something, but that's about it. Vanilla plus sugar.
Vanilla plus sugar.
Yeah, it's just like
they love their
caramelized a little bit, but it's kind of granulated.
They love their simple recipes, don't they?
Yeah.
Like, boy, I don't know. It would simplify things, though, to know what you're going to have to eat every single fucking day. Without
burnt tortillas and fucking bean slop.
Bean slop.
Like watery beans, you know, dripping out the sides. Burnt tortillas.
Jesus Christ. Burnt slap.
Oh, you want to listen?
Burnt slap.
She wants to join in the fun. Hold on.
All right, join in the chant. Come on in.
All right. I think you're on speaker now.
Speaker. Salutations. And now here's some Otmar Liebert for your listening pleasure. Yes, homie. What's up, man? Hi. Flautas? Yeah, see how much easier and simpler it would be if you knew that every goddamn day of the year you were going to eat one or more of the following ingredients in some sort of combination and on assorted tortillas. We would have some cheese, some queso. Some sort of meats, some carne.
You ever tried gorditas?
Gorditas?
Yeah.
How is that different from flautas or burritos or tacos, really?
What they do is they take the masa. They take the masa, and it's kind of thick. Like, so you have the tortilla, which is kind of thin, like a corn tortilla.
Yeah.
Like, the gordita is like a thicker... thing of it, just kind of fried, maybe like three or four times thicker than a tortilla.
Uh-huh.
It's almost like a bread, but like a heavy kind of thick bread, like almost like a tamale thickness, but like
yeah,
fried.
Yeah, I got you. I've had a gordita.
Yeah, they're pretty tasty if they do them right.
Personally, I like those better than tortillas. Those, you know, that like almost like. It's almost like pita-ish, you know, but a little fluffier, a little more pillowy. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I can deal with that.
Yeah, those are pretty bad.
Fajitas are also very good.
Oh, yeah.
Fajitas?
It's all good if it's done right.
Yeah, fajitas are a favorite. I can dig that.
Fajitas?
What? Fajitas?
Fajitas?
Yeah, fajitas.
Yeah.
tortilla.
Vegeta.
Yeah, you put on a tortilla with some corn and some Frijoles. Yeah, homie. Frijoles and tortillas make a pretty good foundation when you're gonna put the corn on and the queso.
Don't forget the guacamole.
The guacamole and the jalapeno. The jalapeno, of course. How dare I mispronounce and misrepresent their culture? Listen, pal.
Yeah, you're making me hungry.
I think the champagne and the filet mignon jokes have gone far enough. Hey, I want some filet mignon. Check it out. My neighbor made us a rack of ribs the other night. Kind of like in appreciation for, like, I was doing all the snow blowing and all that stuff. And, we have, like, a shared driveway. So I was all jolly out there just fucking snow blowing away. Yeehaw! No problem. And he's like, hey, he has a smoker and all this stuff. And so he does ribs and stuff all the time. And he's like, next time I make some ribs, man, I'll hook you up with a rack. So I'm like, all right, cool. And dude, they were fucking huge. They were like dinosaur ribs. It was fucking awesome. And he had like he had like a secret little mix of a couple different rub, mixes.
Yeah.
And because it wasn't barbecue. It was rubbed, and man, it was righteous, man. They were fucking awesome. Holy shit, that was good. Like mouth watering, like slipping off the bone in your mouth and all just like melting away, and you're like, oh my god. And that was on the reheat. I didn't even eat them when he first gave them to me. They were like fresh out of the smoker and shit. I should have eaten them instantly. I didn't. I waited, and then that was on the reheat, and they were fucking astounding. I was like, holy shit. Yeah.
They like cool down, they get all like hard and chewy, and like you just they like stick to the bone, like the meat.
Were they pork ribs or beef ribs?
They're pork.
Yeah, they tend to be a little smaller. The straps are already yeah, I know what you mean.
Yeah, they weren't very good. I tried to eat them later, like
like the smokehouse style, dude.
Yeah.
Oh boy, I'll tell you what, I miss that.
Yeah, I can tear up ribs.
Oh yeah, that's the thing. If they if they weren't quite as expensive as they are, man, it'd be a. I could stack up some racks, man, and go for it. But I chowed on these though the other night. I chowed on them till I almost passed out with the meat sweats, man. I'm not kidding. It was a full rack, and I was just like, they were so big, and I just kept going to town. I mean, it was one of those things. The rub mix was really great, but it was one of those ones. It's potent enough where you like keep tasting it like into the next day.